This call is now being recorded.
Today's lecture, we will see about the. My sound is clear to you, I think so. आवाज आ रही है आप लोगों को? Anybody? Are you getting my voice? Hello? Arif? Mobile, you are getting my voice? हेलो मेरी आवाज आ रही है अब तक पहुंच रही है क्या एनीबॉडी?
सर बहुत स्लो है, आवाज आ रही है लेकिन बहुत धीमे आ रही है।
अभी आई कैसे? ओके नॉट इज ओके
यस सर।
Shall we start? We will start now. In today's lecture, you will learn about the prevention of air pollution and some standard regarding the ambient air quality based on the PCB air norms. We'll see in prevention of air pollution, the controlling at the source, particulate pollution control, and the gases pollution control. The prevention of air pollution, since the industrial revolution, people have been polluting the earth like never before. There is rarely a place today that has not been subjected to pollution in one form or another. The key to have a healthier life is to adopt measures that do not pollute air so much, because we all have a role to play when it comes to creating a healthy environment for living. So आज आप देखेंगे कि हर जगह इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन अर्बनाइजेशन हो रहा है और मास प्रोडक्शन की वजह से वी नीड लार्ज क्वान्टिटीज ऑफ फूड एंड प्रोडक्ट्स for our daily use. Due to this industrialization, many such pollution are released in the environment through the air or contaminating the water or contaminating the soil. So here we are talking about the air pollution, that is contamination of the air by the such soils. So that's why nowadays it is very, very problematic, since in every field there are pollution, or we are doing doing the harmful to the environment. And tomorrow is the 5th June, that is the World Environment Day also. I shared the some news to you today. Came into inclab. You might be seen. And to stop this pollution, to stop this pollution for the healthy environment for the living beings, हमको इसको रोकना पड़ेगा. Otherwise, जिस तरह बीमारियां फैल रही हैं, ये इस तरह फैलते रहेंगे. और इससे ह्यूमन बीइंग और लिविंग थिंग्स जो है वो डिस्टर्ब होते रहेंगे, उनको इफेक्ट होते रहेगा. तो हाउ यू कैन कंट्रोल द एयर पोल्यूशन? एयर पोल्यूशन आप कैसे कंट्रोल कर सकते हो? इसके लिए तीन तरीके बताए गए हैं। फर्स्ट वन इज कंट्रोलिंग एट द सोर्स। कंट्रोलिंग एट द सोर्स यानी जहां से पोल्यूशन निकल रहा है, जहां से हमारी एयर पोल्यूट हो रही है, सोर्स पर जहां से निकल रहा है, जहां से पोल्यूशन बन रहा है, वहीं पर उसको कंट्रोल किया जाए, तो वो इन्वायरमेंट में फैलेगा ही नहीं। तो पहला ये जो तरीका है कंट्रोलिंग एट द सोर्स है, जिसको हम आसानी से पोल्यूशन हमारा बन रहा है या तो उसको कम करें या उसको रिड्यूस करें या उसको वहीं पर कंट्रोल कर दें। दूसरा है पर्टिकुलेट पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल, दैट पर्टिकुलेट मैटर दैट इज रिलीज्ड इनटू द एयर ड्यू टू सर्टेन एक्टिविटी, ड्यू टू द ऑटोमोबाइल इंडस्ट्री, ड्यू टू द व्हीकल्स वी आर यूजिंग, दैट मैटर शुड बी कंट्रोल्ड टू अवॉइड द एयर पोल्यूशन। एंड सेकंड थर्ड वन इज द गैसियस पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ गैसेस डायरेक्टली वी आर लिविंग इन टू द एनवायरमेंट एंड दैट विल क्रिएटिंग द हार्मफुल हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम्स इन टू द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स। यू कैन सी हियर द कंट्रोलिंग एट द सोर्स, सोर्स रिलोकेशन, कीपिंग द इंडस्ट्री एरिया, हाउ वी कैन कंट्रोल, कीपिंग द इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया अवे फ्रॉम द रेसिडेंशियल एरिया। तो फर्स्ट थिंग यू कैन डू दैट द इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया यू शुड कीप अवे फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया। तो इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया यू कैन कीप फ्रॉम द अवे फ्रॉम द रेसिडेंशियल एरिया। तो इफ यू डू दैट देन दैट विल बी सम हाउ इट विल कंट्रोल द पोल्यूशन एंड फॉर द इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया इट विल नॉट अफेक्ट द पोल्यूशन एंड द ह्यूमन बींग्स लिविंग दे विल नॉट अफेक्टेड। सेकंड द सोर्स शट डाउन, पोल्यूटन केस केसिंग हजार्डस इफेक्ट्स शुड बी इमीडिएटली इमीडिएटली बार, दैट शुड बी क्लोज्ड इफ देयर इज पोल्यूशन एंड द सोर्स शुड बी शट डाउन एंड द यूज ऑफ दैट सोर्सेस शुड बी इवॉल्वेट और कंप्लीटली इट शुड बी इट विल बी रिमूव और इट शुड बी बैंड और बार। ओके, द फ्यूल एनर्जी सब्स्टिट्यूशन यूजिंग द एनवायरमेंटल फ्रेंडली फ्यूल्स लाइक सीएनजी, बायोफ्यूल्स एंड बायोगैस एक्सेट्रा, तो टू अवॉइड द पेट्रोलियम एंड अदर फॉर्म्स ऑफ एनर्जी दैट्स दे आर रिलीजिंग द पर्टिकुलेट मैटर्स एंड द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एक्सेट्रा गैसेस, हार्मफुल गैसेस इन टू द एनवायरमेंट, सो दैट यू कैन अवॉइड एंड द एनवायरमेंटल फ्रेंडली फ्यूल्स लाइक सीएनजी एंड बायोफ्यूल्स एंड बायोगैस एक्सेट्रा कैन बी यूज। नाउ डेज इट इज वेरी इमर्जिंग थिंग दैट यू कैन प्रोड्यूस द बायोफ्यूल्स दैट इट विल नॉट हैम्पर द एनवायरमेंट एंड मेनी सच प्लांट्स आर नियर बाय अस इज ऑल्सो अवेलेबल ऑन मुरमाड हाईवे। यू कैन गो एंड विजिट द बायोफ्यूल प्लांट। बायोगैस प्लांट्स आर ऑल्सो देयर इन वेयर द मास पॉपुलेशन आर लिविंग एट वन प्लेस, और डोमेस्टिक प्लांट्स आर ऑल्सो देयर एंड वी आर using that biogas for the our kitchen that is cooking purpose। तो ये कंट्रोलिंग एट द सोर्स में हम कैसा कर सकते हैं कि इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया को सेपरेट कर सकते हैं हमारे रेसिडेंशियल एरिया से, या फिर जो जहाँ से ये पोल्यूशन और हजार्ड पैदा हो रहा है उसको बैंड कर दें, उसको बंद कर दें, और साथ ही ऐसी गैसेस और ऐसे फ्यूल इस्तेमाल करें जो कि इन्वायरमेंटल फ्रेंडली हो। उसके बाद चौथा जो है कि गुड ऑपरेटिंग प्रैक्टिसेस, गुड मेंटेनेंस, कंट्रोल ड्राइविंग स्पीड कैन रिड्यूस द पोल्यूटेंट इमिशन। तो दिस आल्सो हेल्प अस टू अवॉइड द पोल्यूशन। इट शुड बी गुड ऑपरेटिंग प्रैक्टिसेस, गुड मेंटेनेंस, कंट्रोल ड्राइविंग स्पीड। बहुत ज़्यादा स्पीड से भी वी आर पोल्यूटिंग द इमिशन से एंड दैट विल क्रिएट द प्रॉब्लम। ऑल्सो द व्हीकुलर इमिशन कंट्रोल दैट इज रेगुलेशन ऑफ पी यू सी दैट पोल्यूशन अंडर कंट्रोल, चेकिंग on highways are generally done by the traffic police. Good quality fuel with the all attitudes can control the vehicle emission. So this we can avoid the pollution, and that by adopting such things, it is very important and very necessary nowadays to avoid the polluting our environment. Now the second word, the particulate pollution control. Particulate matter is the all solids and liquid part. What is the particulate matters? The solids and the liquid particles suspended in airs that are called as particulate matter. Many of which are hazardous. उसमें से बहुत से जो हैं वो harmful होते हैं. This complex mixture contain constant dust, dust pollen, okay, pollen grain of the your जिसको zero बेजेदान हम बोलते हैं आमतौर पर. Soot, smoke from the industry and the liquid droplets, these are nothing but the particulate matters, and they are suspended into air and they are harmful, they are hazardous, and they will create the severe problems or affecting the human organ and animal organs and trees also. They will affect all the living things in we can say. Also these five major groups or processes can avoid this. The settling chamber, you can remove the particles, particulate matters, and then inertial separator or cyclone separator, also the electrostatic precipitator, and bag houses, filters, and wet scrubbers. These are the different methods to avoid the polluting the environment, that particulate matters can be collected or can be avoided to release into the environment. So one by one we can see the settling chambers. It is simplest device collecting the dust of size 10 micrometer, okay, 10 micrometer in any minus 10 raised to minus 4 meter, you can say. This small size of dust can be collected in this simple device. This you can see in the figure, you can able to see this. The dirty gases is entering from here, and then particulate matters, they are collected from this hoppers. You can see the hoppers here. I am showing with the red arrow. You can see these two hoppers. You can see so here the dust is collecting through this chamber, and the green gas is released from the outlet. So this one is the outlet, and the gas is passed through the settling chamber, and the particulate matter or solid matters through the gravity is removed, and the gas stream enters the chamber where the velocity of gas is reduced. Large particles drop out of the gas and are recollected in the hoppers. You can see the hoppers. Two hoppers are showing there, and dust hoppers they are called, and the dust is collected, or particulate matters or solid particles are collected, and green gas are released to the environment. Then second type to avoid the gases to clean air, and that should be removed. So you can see here, this is the process achieved by the sudden change in the direction of gas flow. So what happened? The dust particle is spinning in the circular path. As a result of the particle collide with the walls of this chamber, cyclone body on wall, and fall to the bottom of the pieces. So you can see here, the dirt is collected here, or dust is collected from this bottom side. Bottom you can see, I am showing with the arrow. Okay, then this dirt is collected, and the clean gas or clean air is released outward from the top. Okay, so this, the dirt air is in inlet from this vessel, and the circular motion of this air, what happen, this particle they will collide with the walls, and they will settle down and fall at the bottom of the vessel, and that can be collected from the bottom apertures. So likewise, this cyclone inertial separation or cyclone chambers are there where we can dust will be collected. This second type, and then third type is the electrostatic precipitator. Generally, these precipitator we have seen many industries, they are using this electrostatic precipitator because in thermal power plant also we are using the electrostatic precipitator to collect the particulate matter, such as if you are burning the coal, the ashes, some ashes they will drop, they are heavier, they are called bottom ashes, but some ashes they flew with the air, their particle size is very small, and that is that can be flow with the air and harmful for the environment. So to collect that charge particle, then the opposite charge is applied to the plates, and these plates are called as electrostatic plates. And here the if the particles are positive charge, then the plates are provided a negative charge, and then they will attract the particle, and then the particle deposit on the plate and then drop off. So likewise, you can use the electrostatic precipitator. So high voltage power supply is there, and the charges are developed on the opposite charge are developed as a particle having, and these plates, you can see I'm showing with the arrow, these plates, they attract the particle. The particle of the flue gases, they will hit the electrostatic precipitator, and they deposit at bottom, and they are called as the fly ashes. So that any industry, I'm just telling for the coal burning, the ashes are produced, and it may be used for another where dust collection can be done. So these are nothing but the electrostatic precipitator, they are called. This passing the particle laden gases between the high voltage discharge electrodes. These are the electrodes you can see, and from there the gases are passed, and the particle get charged and collected on the ground electrodes. At intervals, electrodes are prepped to dislodge the collected particles from the electrodes, which then fall into the hopper at the bottom of the precipitator. So this is the working of the electrostatic precipitator. We will provide inlet to the gases, the particles, the particulate matter with the this air, they will come in contact with the electrostatic precipitator. The charge particle, they are attracted at the electrostatic plate, and they deposit there, and they will collect it from the bottom hoppers. And the clean smoke or clean gas is released to the atmosphere. Okay, so this is nothing but the electrostatic precipitator. Similarly, the bag houses filters, this method is most often used type of device. The fabric filters or a bag house remove dust from a gas stream by passing the stream through a porous fabric. So you can see the metal bars with the shaking mechanism is there, and these bags are hanging from the shaking mechanism, and then air, that is dusty air or dirt air, is injected from the bottom, and they will pass through these cloths or the fabrics, and the particles, they are deposited on the fabrics, and the clean air is out. And then after shaking, this can be, the dust can be collected in the hopper, and the dust will be released from the bottom portion of the bag house filters. So these are the fourth one. You can avoid the release of particulate matters into the or a control of the particulate matter to the And then wet scrubber is the another method to clean the air with the particulate matter. The objective of a scrubber is to trap the particulate matter in liquid droplets. So you can see the exhaust gases is inlet from here, and the absorbent solution, they are showered at the top. What happens? The scrubbed exhaust gas will out, and the particulate matter with this gas, they are collected as a water, and then wastewater out. So excess absorbent solution is then out from here, which is absorbed already the particulate matter present in the gas. So water subsides of 20 flows from the bottom of the scrubber, and the particulate is allowed to settle, and clarified water is recirculated. So that is nothing but the ways you can control the particulate matters. So these are the ways you can control the particulate matters. So here we have already seen the first is the simplest device, the collecting dust size of 10 micrometer, that is greater than 10 micrometer size, and it is in settling chamber. Then the inertial separator, we have seen this chamber where the air is poured and circulated in a circular way, so that the matter, particulate matter, they will come in contact with the wall and they will fall at the bottom. Then we have seen the electrostatic precipitator and bag house filters. All these are the methods to avoid the release of particulate matter into the air. And then we have seen the wet scrubbers. Now we will go through the gases pollution control. The gases pollutants are controlled by means of three basic techniques: absorption, that is concentrate the pollutant in a liquid. The gases pollutants are controlled by means of three basic techniques. First one, the absorption, concentrate the pollutant in a liquid. Okay. Then absorption, concentrate the pollutant in on solid. Absorption, the concentrate the pollutant in a liquid. Adsorption, concentrate the pollutant on the solid. Combustion, direct incineration of the pollutant, that is nothing but combustion. So these three techniques can be used to control the gases pollution. And very large amount of gases are released from the industries nowadays, and they are the causes of the global warming and climate change, you can say. These are very harmful for the inhaling of the human beings, and they will disturb the digestive systems of animals also. Yeah, these harmful gases. So these techniques can be employed singly or in a combination. So this technique, absorption, adsorption, combustion, they can be employed singly, or they can be used in a combination. They are effective against the major greenhouse gases as well. So we'll see the absorption means the process is selected to remove gases pollutant by dissolution into a liquid solvent such as water. The liquid in and gas out. This you can see here, the liquid is supplied and then it is out. And gas is in and gas is out. What happened? The gas and liquid are supplied in a chamber, and absorption or the stifling column, they are absorb the harmful gases and clean gases out. Okay, and another method is the adsorber method, and that can be through the solid particle. You can see the carbon bed is there, the dirty gas is supplied and condense out. That condensed gate will be, water will be coming out, and then this passes through the bed, and the carbons or dirt gases are collected, and the cleaning by gas from the top, it is out. So this is the steam for the generation. दिस इज द एडसॉर्बल दिस प्रोसेस वेयर गैसेस वेपर्स और लिक्विड आर कंसंट्रेटेड ऑन अ सॉलिड सरफेस एंड दे आर एडसॉर्ब द हार्मफुल गैसेस और दे कैन कंडेंस द हार्मफुल गैसेस एंड दैट विल बी और एंड क्लीन गैसेस कैन बी रिलीज फ्रॉम द टॉप. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एडसॉर्बेंट इन इंडस्ट्री यूज टूडेज आर द बॉक्साइट, activated carbon, activated alumina or silica gel, all these are used for the adsorbent to absorb the gases or to control the gases pollution. Then the combustion is nothing but the burning, you can say. This method for the removal of volatile organic compound, volatile organic compound, VOC, this method is removal of the volatile organic compound since they can be decomposed to the carbon dioxide or water. So air is introduced and fuel is for burning, air is introduced and then cooling catalysts are there. It's catalytic reactor, this part you can say, and post catalytic mixing is there and the combustion and burn gases. So likewise you can do the this different method to clean the or to control the gases pollution. Now there are some ambient air quality standard that is given by the air that is Prevention and Control of Pollution Act, PCP you can say, in 1981 was enacted by the central government. The objective of arresting the deterioration of air quality. So, due to the increasing concern over the environmental damage to the industrialization and other effects that is creating the air pollution, the government came with the objective, the central government came with the objective of arresting the deterioration of that air quality. So, prevention, control of pollution, this board. They are prepared an act. That act is 1981, given by the central government. It describes main functions of Central Pollution Control Board. That is, it is described the main function of the Central Pollution Control Board, such CPCB, are as follows. So we are following some CPCB laws for air quality also, on water quality also. So you can see the first one to advise the central government on any matter concerning the improvement of the quality of the air and prevention, control and abatement of air pollution. So this board, the duties of this board are to plan and cause to be executed a nationwide program for the prevention, control and abatement of air pollution. So these are the objectives that is set by the Government of India, the main functions of the CPCB, that is Central Pollution Control Board. Also to provide technical assistance and guidance to the State Pollution Control Board, SPCB, that is State Pollution Control Board, they will assist them and they will guide them how the pollution can be controlled and prevented. Then to carry out and sponsor investigation research related to the prevention and control of the air pollution. Also, they are sponsoring the investigation or the research related with the prevention and control of the air pollution. Also, to collect, compile, publish technical and statistical data related to air pollution and to lay down and annual standards for the quality of air. So this CPCB, that is Central Pollution Control Board, these are the objectives of that CPCB or the main function of the CPCB. And also they are, after studying and they are releasing the standard for the quality of air. So here you can see the ambient air quality standards in India, which is given by the Central Pollution Control Board. So this, the pollutant, you can see the column number one, I will say कॉलम नंबर वन इज फॉर द पोल्यूशन, कॉलम नंबर टू इज द टाइम वेटेड एवरेज, एंड कॉलम नंबर थ्री इज द इंडस्ट्रियल रेसिडेंशियल रूरल एंड अदर एरियाज कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इन एम्बियंट एयर एंड देन इकोलॉजिकल सेंसिटिविटी एरिया डिफाइंड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एयर स्टैंडर्ड. So likewise, the fourth column is there. If you see the sulfur dioxide, that is milligram per cubic meter, the annual time weighted average, annual or 24 hours, so 50 to 80, this for concentration in ambient air, it should be 50 to 80. Milligram per cubic meter. Okay. Or where the sensitive area government notified there only 20. This range is given. The lower range is 20 and upper range is 80 in both the cases. In industrial, residential, and rural areas, and where the ecological sensitive areas also the lower value is 20 and the upper value is 80. Then the nitrogen dioxide, its range concentrated in ambient temperature, it is given as 40 to 80 at that milligram per cubic meter, and that microgram per cubic meter is given, and that is for ecological sensitive area it is 30 to 80. So these are the ambient quality standard which are given by the standard given by the Indian government or the Central Pollution Control Board. Now you can see the particulate matter size less than 10 micrometer or PM10, you can say. So their value, standard value for the industrial, residential, and rural areas are 60 to 100. And same for the ecological sensitive area. Then particulate matter size less than 2.0 micrometer or PM2.5. So this is from 40 to 60 in both the cases. You can see here these standards concentration in the ambient air, it is given. Then ozone O3, this is 100 to 80 or 100 to 180. Which is given in the residential area, ecological area, maybe this 100 to 180, that also 100 to 180, I think so, there is some mistake. The lead, that is the shisha you are telling in Hindi and PV in the chemical term, its value is 0.5 to 1. In industrial area and the ecological sensitive area. Then the carbon monoxide milligram per meter cube, 0 to 0.4 or 0 to 0.4, both cases the given. And similarly for ammonia and NH3, microgram per cubic meter, 100 to 400, the range is given. In between that will be the concentrated ambient air quality, concentrated or ambient air quality, that is the acceptable limits given by this. Similarly, the benzene C6H6 having the value of 5, benzopyrene BAP particulate phase only, it is also some 1 microgram per cubic meter. Sorry, 1 nanogram per cubic meter, that is NG. NG means the nanogram per cubic meter. And the arsenics annually, it is 6 to 16. And nickel, it is 20 to 20. Okay, nanogram per cubic meter. So these are the standard ambient air quality standard in India, which is released by the Central पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड एंड वी हैव टू मैनेज दिस द क्वालिटी ऑफ एयर विथ रेफरेंस टू दिस. ओके, सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द फर्स्ट से नो टू द पोल्यूशन, वी अवॉइड द पोल्यूशन एंड देन वी हैव सीन द एयर pollution is a major environment issue. It can affect the health and the life support system as well. Also, it is necessary to control air pollution to save life and make the earth happy once again. And we have studied the prevention of air pollution, that is the controlling at the source. Controlling at the source means where there the pollution is released, at that point only we control the pollution. Then particulate pollution control, the particulate matter can be controlled by different activity, including static precipitator, settling chambers, and biogas filters, etc. We can use and we can control the particulate pollution control. And then we have also seen the gases pollution control, and that may be, you can remember the combustion, the absorption, and the adsorption. So these three categories are the control the gases pollution. So these are the different methods to control the air pollution. It may be control at the source, maybe control of the particulate matter, maybe control of the gases matters or gases control. So these are we have learned today in today's lecture. Also, we have seen the some standard given by the your India ambient air quality standard that can be remembered or that can be compromised with the air compared with the air quality of your local area. So this is nothing but what about today's lecture, and you can, I think so, understand, and we will stop here. If you have any question, you may ask. Otherwise, we will stop here. कोई क्वेश्चन है किसी को तो पूछ सकते हैं. Any question, anybody? Otherwise, we will stop here.